So it's starting to get cold and the weather's changing and the temperature's dropping at night. Things are getting kind of chilly. And if you have one of these buddy heaters, you kind of know some of its limitations. Well, I'm going to show you how to maximize this thing so you can get the most heat possible without using electricity. So if you're unaware of how these things work, you take a propane canister, you hook it up, you turn it on, you ignite it, and it creates heat. It creates heat through this white block right here. And that's great. It's very effective, it works. However, there is a limitation. All the heat that this thing generates doesn't go anywhere. It sort of just radiates around it, and then it goes up. It doesn't come out. It doesn't come to you. It doesn't go into a space wherever you have this, outside, in a tent, or wherever, right? If you're camping, that sort of thing. It just sort of creates this big heat bubble around itself, but the air doesn't flow, it doesn't travel. So in order to maximize your buddy heater for full effect, you need something like this right here. HidaLife sent me this, and they basically asked me if I'd like to do a review, and I said yes. They're not sponsoring the video, but they did provide it so I could make a review. What this actually is a six-bladed stove fan. And what happens is heat, because it's made out of aluminum, right? Heat makes the fan turn. No power needed, just heat. This is amazing. So basically you take this fan and you stick it on top of your heater, and the power of heat generates the fan, spins the blade, and blows it into whatever space you're at to help circulate that heat so it doesn't just stay in a bubble. It actually comes to where it fills the space, man. So it greatly works to maximize the effect of your heater by moving the air. I've been wanting one of these for a long time. What makes this so advantageous for me, it doesn't require batteries. I have a fan that I've used in the past to help move the air, but it uses batteries. And that's a little bit of a problem. We recently just came through Hurricane Helene. We didn't have power, and I went through 30, 40 batteries just making a fan work. So since the temperature is dropping and things are getting a lot colder, you know, that's a sort of a detriment. And the fact that this uses heat, which is the whole reason why you're using this, to move that air, to give you some air circulation and to disperse the heat throughout the space you're in, fantastic. Now, this particular kit that HidaLife sends comes with a bracket to connect it to the grate on the heater, and also a pretty cool little thermometer. So the thermometer gives you an idea of basically the heat, how much heat is coming off of this thing. It's fantastic. So you have a complete kit. You've got the fan, nice little handle, you've got the bracket to mount it, and you also have a thermometer to make sure things don't get too hot. It's a simple install, following the directions. You basically hook it, and you're going to hook it to the grate of your heater. And it's going to make the slot area sort of even and level, because that's what you want. You want it to be level so that when you slide your fan in, the direction that the fan is going to place or displace the air, you want it to be level. You want the air and the heat to go into the space, because you're trying to heat more surface area than just the immediate area around the heater. This fan, that's what it does, is it blows it. And it doesn't use power. It's fantastic. All right. Let's see what happens. Whole thing is made out of aluminum, so it transfers the heat. Ooh, it wants to go. Almost. So anyway, check it out. That thing's going pretty good now. The heat's going. It's really quiet. The camera makes it hard to kind of get an idea how fast it's really spinning. It's spinning really quick. So there you go. Now, you don't want to let these things get too hot. When I use my heater, I usually use it on low, because I want the bottle to last as long as it can. I primarily use this in a camper van or wherever I need to, tent, that sort of thing. It's actually putting off pretty fair amount of heat. It's pretty good. And we actually lit this outside, where the wind's been blowing. That's the noise you've been hearing out of the heater. This thing is really silent. So yeah, I appreciate HidaLife sending me this. It's pretty nice. I think it's going to be very useful. I haven't quite figured out the best place to put this magnetic thermometer, which is pretty cool. Has a good range on it. Basically 100 all the way up to like 900. Very nice. Put it on the grate. This thing's blowing pretty good. You can feel some of the heat coming off of it. And we're actually outside and there's wind today and this thing is still moving some air. So I'm happy with this. This is gonna work very well. No batteries, basically just heat. I'm already making heat and it has a pretty good volume. So with a little setup like this, you could be ready for natural disasters or lose power, that kind of thing. Very useful. We use the heater in our camper van when we need it, and having this product to kind of blow the air into the van, which should make it so much more comfortable. I used to use an electric fan, or basically a battery fan, and that thing chewed through batteries. And then I went with a USB fan, which was slightly better. But the fact that this doesn't use any energy at all, as far as like I have to provide the energy, it just uses the heat that comes off the heater that's already heating, is great. Stove fans are awesome. So I do have a link in the description if you'd like to check it out for yourself. But I appreciate HidaLife for sending it to me, because I'm totally going to use this every chance I get. If the heater's on, that thing's going to be blowing. Makes sense to me. So anyway, there you go. See you later. Take it easy. Bye-bye. Well, if you want to like comment and subscribe and share and all that jazz, please do. Helps the channel. So, there you go. Be safe.